Hi, my name is Julian, and I'm a product manager for TwinCAT automation software, especially in the area connectivity. And today, I'm going to tell you about the TwinCAT 3 OPC UA Nodeset Editor. We are going to go about the first steps on how to use it and how to get your first namespace up and running. Have fun watching. As you can see, I've already opened a TwinCAT solution. It's named TwinCAT Tutorial Solution with a TwinCAT XAE tutorial project. And under PLC, I've created a PLC project called Untitled 1. For this showcase, we've created a structure. It's called ST my structure, and it contains three variables. It contains my boolean, my int 16, and my float. And in main, we have instantiated this structure twice, and we also have an FB timer with some logic to update the variables. If we want to use this project and deploy it to our TwinCAT OPC UA server, we have to make sure that under the TwinCAT PLC project settings, under target files, the TMC file option is enabled, because without that file, the OPC UA server will not be able to use this project. If we've checked that this is true, we can activate the configuration and we can restart TwinCAT in run mode. And then once that is done, we can log in to see the values of our structs in the main program. We can see the bools toggle and the integers and floats increment every 500 milliseconds. So let's imagine we want to take these variables and show them via OPC UA. We are going to look at the TwinCAT OPC UA sample client for that, which I'm just starting right now. And it's configured to connect to localhost, and we are requesting our endpoints. We have three endpoints to choose from, and note this OPC UA server is already pre-initialized. How you can do that, please refer to the OPC UA server configuration for that, documentation for that, sorry. So we log in with our OPC UA user and a password, and under our root node and objects, we can see also the PLC 1 node, but we do not see any information about our main program or its containing variables. To achieve that we get that information there, one way is to use the Nodeset Editor. So we've started the Nodeset Editor, and what we want to do now is get the information from the PLC visible in our OPC UA namespace. The editor has just checked its license, and for this video tutorial, we have as a requirement that you have installed and licensed it already. How to do that, you can also get from the OPC UA Nodeset Editor documentation. But let's get right ahead, create a new project. We'll leave it in the default naming, TwinCAT Nodeset Project. And by leaving the check mark, a Nodeset with a name and a model having that namespace URI is created. So under objects, the same objects folder we've already seen, we are going to create a folder and we're going to name it mystruct1. And after saving that, we are going to create another folder to represent our other structure, mystruct2. And now after saving this, there's multiple ways to go about getting our variables where we need them to be. One of them is browsing for the types manually, and we want to represent the same structure. So we get a bool and just drag it and drop it onto the folder where we want to have it. And next, we want to instantiate the int 16. But as there's a lot of types, it will not always be as easy to find the variables. But in this case, yeah, the int 16, it's here. But an alternative would be to search for the variable you want to use. So we are looking for float. The search is minimized to the search results, and it makes it a lot easier to just drag and drop what you need. And now the question would be, how do I map those variables to the PLC? And you will get how and why I'm not creating the mystruct2 first. We are going to use the target browser for this, which comes embedded with the Nodeset editor. The target browser is a software to access the information from the PLC. So that machine is our local machine. Port 851 is the same port TwinCAT uses, and we can see our main program and its containing structures. And if we want to map that information, we can just take my bool and drag and drop it onto the node that represents that information. Same goes for the float and int. And you will notice there's type checking involved for simple data types. So we finish this. And this can be a lot of work if you have many variables to add that extension you see there to every variable. But there's another convenient way for simple data types, and that is to select all the symbols you want to create and map just by clicking shift, holding shift and clicking, and using shift while dragging, you have the possibility to instantiate and map the variables at the same time. So that's what I just did. And we now have the variables named according to their symbol name in the PLC. And we're going to leave it like that. But you see the TwinCAT symbol variable extension is created the same as it was before. And now all we need to do is deploy the configuration to the local OPC UA server using this button. The project is being exported. And all we need to do now is restart the OPC UA server. There's many ways you can do that, but the easiest is to just restart the TwinCAT system, because that will also restart the OPC UA server. But note, you do not need to restart the TwinCAT system. You could also just restart the OPC UA server. And while it restarts, we can go onto the TwinCAT sample client. It is already restarted now. And the view has not yet updated, so we're just going to disconnect real quick and reconnect. Enter our user data again. And once we have done that, let's see what our namespace looks like. And no surprise, under objects, we have my struct 1 and my struct 2 and the variables contained in each folders. And by dragging them to our watch list, we can see that the variables update according to their values in the PLC. And this is how you use the TwinCAT OPC UA Nodeset Editor to design and connect the namespace for your OPC UA server. Thank you very much for your attention.